Hi guys, I am finally getting around to playing Far Harbor. It has been a long time since I actually played Fallout 4. Believe it or not, I have not played since before the survival mode changes. And of course, an awful lot has changed. So I thought I'd discuss with you how that's affected Frank. Those of you who followed the playthrough so far know that Frank was very much a power armor and engineer style build. He uses a lot of weapons, a lot of different weapons, rifles, sniper rifles, shotguns, and big guns. And therein lies the problem. Frank has been working slowly towards becoming an expert at rocket launchers and the Fat Man, but in the survival mode game now, that's not really a very viable build. Not just because those weapons are insanely heavy, but because their ammunition is insanely heavy too. That you probably couldn't play with both of those weapons in your inventory with enough ammunition for fights. But even one of them, you're going to have to take so little ammunition that you will be running backwards and forwards, doing loot runs and ammunition refresh so often, I think it would get irritating. So, I had two choices. I either start a whole new playthrough and do a new build, or I respec Frank's build just a little. And that is what I did. I respec'd it. Not much, actually. What I did, pretty much, was I dropped the ranks in big gun. I kept explosives because grenades are still useful. They're not that heavy, and I think I'll continue to use those. But I dropped the heavy gunner perks and the two perks, steady aim, which were really there for the heavy guns. And instead, what I did was I took nuclear physicist, which seems like a reasonable thing for Frank to take anyway, as he is an engineer. And of course, it allows my fusion cores to last twice as long. I didn't have a fusion core problem because I've got loads of them, but of course they now weigh something. The fewer I can carry, the better. Of course, I still want to carry lots of junk back to my settlements. You may also notice I've put ranks in bashing. And bashing is, that's where you basically smash things in the face or, you know, with a bayonet. I thought that might be useful. I thought I'd try it out. I know in the survival game getting that close may well be a bad idea, but it may also be a better idea than, you know, carrying so much ammo that I miss all the time. If something gets in my face, maybe I bash it very quickly and then shoot it. And this is going to be especially useful as I can't carry quite as many weapons as I used to. You have almost certainly also noticed that Frank is wearing completely different clothes now. He's no longer using the vault suit. He is using this shirt and pants. And there are a few reasons for the change in his armor. The most obvious one is he finally learnt the secret of ballistic weave, and of course with his engineering skills was able to make a very, very tough shirt and a very, very tough hat. That hat is way tougher than the helmet he was wearing, and that shirt is way tougher than the vault suit. I have also changed the pieces of armor that are on his person. They're not actually the strongest or best that he has, but they are pretty much amongst some of the lightest while still having some good legendary bonuses. I really wanted to keep the weight down, so I've used pretty damned light items, and I've used the ultra light modification. I am not going to be relying too much on that armor because, of course, Frank is still a power armor character. But it means I have less things on my person, and that is definitely going to be important in survival mode. His armor value is actually pretty high. It's higher than it was before anyway because of the ballistic weave, 272, which is not too bad when he has to step out of the powered armor. Obviously, he tries not to do that as much as possible. The new weight restrictions also means I have to take less weaponry with me, partly because weapons, you know, they do weigh you down, but the more weapons I have, the more ammunition I need, unless they all use the same ammunition, which is not usual. So what I have decided upon, I think, I haven't locked this down yet, But my main rifle is going to be my plasma rifle, the Experiment 18A. I've got this one modified pretty much to the max. This is a good medium range weapon. This will be what I use in most fights, I think. I'm going to continue taking my sniper rifle. I did consider using a short stock and a short barrel and using it for the scope shots, but it does reduce the range quite a lot. The full stock doesn't make too much difference in weight anyway, so the difference between full stock and marksman stock is minimal from a weight point of view. But the barrel, there is a difference. If I go to the short light barrel, I save 1.5, but it massively reduces the range, and this is my sniper rifle. It's still pretty heavy though, I'm not too happy with that. It's almost 15, twice the weight of my plasma rifle. Energy weapons seems to be the way to go, but I'm reluctant to go anywhere without my sniper rifle. This is the one that shoots the extra projectile, so hopefully I get a little extra damage. For the short range, I also have my combat shotgun of exploding. Now this could be a little dangerous. I do double radius on my explosions because of my perks, and I think that applies to the legendary effect as well. This means at the very short range, this is going to be devastating, but at point blank, it could kill me. Hence the reason you see a bayonet on it and the fact that I'm taking bash. I'm hoping if something gets really close, I can bash it, backstep a little, and shoot it without killing myself. That's the general idea. As you can see, I've cut this one down to save weight wherever possible, including the magazine. This is not something I want to spam, so I don't necessarily want a large magazine. The same is true on the sniper rifle as well. I've saved weight by having a very small magazine, and you can also see I have no muzzle. I'm less worried about recoil and more worried about carry weight. And I think that's about it. It does seem like there are a lot of changes, but honestly I don't think it's going to feel that different in the end. Frank is still going to be running around in the blue power armor, and he didn't really use the Fat Man and the rocket launcher that much anyway. He predominantly used either the sniper rifle or whichever his medium range rifle was. So it's probably going to feel very little difference, apart from me complaining even more about the fact that I can't carry anything. However, there you have it. That's it. That is Frank ready for survival mode, and I am now ready to play Far Harbor.